Hello, my name is Dennis Schatz and I'm a HRSA trainer through HRSA OIT department. Today I will show you how to connect your laptop to your docking station. Whenever you have a laptop, one of the first things you should notice is that what type of the battery the laptop actually has. If I take a look at my laptop right now, you will notice that it has what's called an extended life battery. Extended life battery means that it sticks outside of the laptop such as this. If you have a different battery, which is not extended life, usually it will be flush with the laptop and it will not extend beyond the end of the actual laptop. Please take a look at your laptop right now and notice what type of battery it has. Once you find out what type of battery you have, you will be able to move on to the docking station itself. The docking station is a very nifty device which will allow you to connect all your peripherals directly to it through the back. You do not have to do it yourself because the technicians will do it for you. However, this particular docking station allows you to automatically connect all of the peripherals such as, let's say, your mouse, your keyboard, your monitor to the docking station and then connect it to the laptop with simply one push of a button. And right now I'm going to show you how to do this. Before we jump into it, I need to explain of the different pieces of the docking station itself. The first piece is the most delicate one, is this piece right over here. This is the connector pins of the docking stations, and this is how the docking station communicates with the laptop. Next to the docking station, you will see the holder pins, which are the two black ones in here. If we look from a side, you will see that they a little bit stick out directly over here. And those holder pins are controlled by the eject button, which is a little bit more in a second. They will hold the laptop in place once it's connected to the docking station to make sure that it doesn't spring up when it's not supposed to. The next piece you'll see is actually consists of four small ones. You have these two metal pins here and these two plastic pins, which are both supported by the springs underneath them. They are the ones responsible for springing up your laptop once it's actually being removed from the docking station after you press the eject button. The next piece after that you will see is this battery extension bar. Remember when I mentioned that your battery could be different kinds. It could be either extended life battery or it could be the regular battery. If your battery is an extended life battery like mine, which means it sticks out outside of the laptop, then you need this bar to be retracted in this position over here like that. If you have your bar, if you have your laptop with a smaller battery which does not stick out, then you need to notice this particular switch in here. If I push it to my right, then in this particular case the retractor bar comes out and then it accompanies for the space needed to take between the laptop and the docking station. As I mentioned to you before, if your laptop has an extended life battery, then you need it to be in retracted position like in mine, like this. The sticker on the top of the docking station will also identify how to operate this retractable bar. To the left top corner, you will notice that right over here is the power button. There's a little teeny tiny button over here. This button is responsible for turning on or turning off the laptop while it's connected to the docking station. And next to it, a little bit bigger one, is the eject button. The eject button is responsible, as I mentioned, for ejecting the laptop when you're ready to do so. However, this eject button needs to be taken in consideration with the security switch on the side. Please be mindful of this piece in here. Whenever your laptop needs to be connected to the docking station, this security switch needs to be in unlocked position, which is right over here, and it will be shown to you as a teeny tiny lock, the padlock that is unlocked. If your docking station is in locked position and you try to connect the laptop to the docking station during that procedure, it will most likely damage the pin. So please make sure that your laptop is in docking station is in unlocked position like this. The next I'm going to show you how to connect your docking station to the laptop. While you're making sure, first of all, that your security switch is in unlocked position, you will take your laptop and then you will match it to the indent right over here in the center, which shows you the center of the docking station, like this. Then whenever you connect it, you will see that it will kind of fall into its own grooves, but this is not enough. You need to press on the laptop in this area, not in this, in the back area over here, press on the laptop so it securely latches with the docking station. You will hear a click when it does that, like this. So once it's currently connected to the docking station, it is very important to understand not to lift up the laptop while it's connected to the docking station. Doing so will undoubtedly damage the laptop and the connector pins on the docking station. So while it's connected, you'll notice that the power runs to the docking station and the power is being displayed to you in an eject button and also in a power button currently showing you the state. You can turn on, for the note, the laptop using the power button on the laptop itself, but while it's connected to the docking station, usually you will use this button over here in the left top corner. To undock the laptop, you will first of all need to make sure that the security lock is again in unlocked position. You may ask yourself, what is the purpose of the security lock? Security lock only takes effect while it's in a docked position, and if I have it currently docked and I push it like this, then I will not be able to accidentally undock the laptop. If I try to press the eject button, nothing happens. So you need to make sure that it is in unlocked position before you will be able to undock your laptop, like this. Whenever you're ready to do so, you made sure that your security switch is in unlocked position. All you have to do is just press the button and you will hear a click telling you that it currently has undocked, like this. Whenever it's in undocked position, you will be able to take the laptop away and the docking station stays in a position where it was before. In a conclusion, I would like to thank you for your time, and I would like to tell you that it will follow up with a slide with all of our information in case if you have any questions about how to dock properly or undock properly your laptop from your docking station. It will have our phone numbers and our email addresses in that slide. We'll also follow up with a brochure which will show you step-by-step instructions on how to do that. Thank you again for your time, and I hope to see you in our future classes.